Get ready. You're tuned in to Tea Time Unfiltered with your girl, Lovely Tea, bringing you the hottest trending topics on social media. Stay connected. Instagram.com/LovelyTea2002.
Hey, you guys. Welcome to Tea Time Unfiltered with your girl, Lovely Tea. And I hope you guys are doing good this afternoon. It is Friday, TGIF, honey. And if you're a 90s kid, you understand that TGIF means thank God it's Friday. So I want to bring you guys this podcast on your way getting off of work, giving you something to listen to. So I wanted to come on here and talk further about the Dwayne Wade situation, okay? So if you joined me the other day, I did a live stream on YouTube, and a lot of people came through. We had about 7,000 people in the house, and I talked about a lot of things. I kept it real about my feelings about Dwayne Wade and Gabrielle Union, how I feel like Gabrielle Union has always come off as a mean girl and as an opportunist. As we all know, at one point, she was dating Chris Howard, who was a football player, but then when she got a chance to move up the social ladder and start dating Dwayne Wade, she did just that, even though Dwayne Wade was married, okay? So I had advised everyone to go and watch Siobhan Funches, that's her maiden name. Siobhan Funches is Dwayne Wade's ex-wife, and I had encouraged everybody to go watch her interviews. Her interviews were done by a woman named Kieta, and basically, it's about a 7-part interview. And so when I had advised everybody who was watching my live stream to go, you know, watch it when they got a chance, all of a sudden, Vlad TV, aka what folks like to call him, Culture Vulture, obviously he's a tea sipper, honey, because I'm telling y'all, not even 24 hours after my live stream, he made an announcement on his YouTube page. He made a flashback video of basically Kieta interviewing Siobhan Funches and was telling everybody to go watch it. He knew that that'd be a topic to hit on because of my live stream, that everybody was going to go watch it. So instead of giving her the views, Kieta, he wanted to take the views from her and have people watch it on Vlad TV. And I called his ass out on Instagram. I'm so tired of folks who want to sneak and sip tea, but then in the same breath act like I don't exist because I don't have a huge corporate backing. But anyways, and I also want to let you guys know that as of yesterday, Kieta decided to do an update on the whole Siobhan Funches, Gabrielle Union situation, because she's the original person who had interviewed them. Now, she did a video. The video is about 10 minutes long. I'm not going to play the full video, but I want you guys to hear some important key parts that Kieta is talking about. And, you know, basically she's calling out Gabrielle Union and saying that Gabrielle Union is wrong for coming out and telling the whole world, you know, to call Zaya Zion and say that, you know, Zaya is now a girl when that is not his biological mother. The Wades are literally acting like Siobhan is not around, like she's dead. But like I told you guys in that live stream, she's very much alive. She does get to see her kids, not on a regular basis. When they were going through the divorce, she was sound and fit to be a mother to those kids. But because of his social status, because he was on one of the number one teams at the time, remember the Miami Heat, they were winning all those NBA championships. He was that guy. So because of that, the judge awarded him full custody and she basically had to sign an NDA and, you know, just basically just fall back into the background. Her story is really sad because her and her mother really looked out for Dwayne Wade, only for him to not only cheat on her, but basically just shit on her entire existence, okay? So I want you guys to go ahead and listen to what Kieta had to say. She posted this video yesterday. Y'all go ahead and check this out.
Hello, this is your beautiful Kieta. And I just want to talk to you today about the situation that's going on between Dwayne Wade, Gabrielle Union, and his ex-wife, Siobhan Funches Wade. Now, many years ago, I did an exclusive interview with Dwayne Wade's ex-wife, Siobhan Funches Wade. Very, very intense, very detailed interview, giving you her side of the story. Now, today, I'm just coming to you all because I was so up close and personal with the situation, and I went to court with her and spent the whole day with her going through stuff and witnessed some stuff. And even though every outside court appointed person agreed that guardian ad litem, the court appointed psychiatrist agreed that Dwayne's ex-wife, Siobhan Funches Wade, should have primary custody of the kids. The judge decided otherwise and went against what the advice of those court-appointed people said. And if you go look at my interview, which you can find on YouTube, it clearly goes over and tell you, Siobhan tells you what her reasoning and what she thought the judge why the judge did it and why Dwayne and, you know, did whatever he did. So you go to my interviews. I want to say after all these years, people still literally go to those interviews and watch them like literally every single day. So people are still actually engaged and want to know what's going on. That's why I felt like I needed to do this to that tonight before I go to bed. Now, this is just my opinion about it. And I'm telling you, this is my opinion. I really feel really bad for Savon at Funches Wade. When I say bad for her, not bad in a way that I think she's helpless. No, not that. Just for Gabrielle Union, the children's stepmother, to come out and announce that Savon's son called him Zaya, I thought was disrespectful. I realized that Gabrielle Union is Zion, aka Zaya's stepmother. And I can appreciate Dwayne, or any man for that matter, marrying a woman that they know is going to love their children as well. But it's not like Savon Funches Wade is not involved in her children's life. It's not like she is not continuously fighting to get, you know, more custody with her children. She's very active and involved in their lives, you know, so, and always have been. My thing is, how are you going to announce this? I think it's a level of respect that people should have, especially when you have an involved parent. You know, and I know, and I don't know how Savon feels. What I do know about her, when I met her, she goes to church all the time. She's very religious. So, but I don't know her relationship with God. All I do know is she participates a lot when it comes down to things with church. So she's been very quiet about it because that's what she chose to do. My only thing is, you know, like how I feel about it as a parent. I have a teenage child too. As a parent, I think, first of all, you know, children go through a whole lot. I'm not saying that Savon and Dwayne's son is not transsexual, you know, and transgender. I'm not saying that. He could have been born that way. Remember, if you look at interviews, Savon did say that she was being abused, allegedly not being abused by Dwayne while she was pregnant with Zion, aka Zaya. But that's, you didn't hear that from me. You can go look at it yourself on the videos. I'm not saying that. But what I'm saying is children go through so much. And at the young age like that, to have a child make a life-changing decision like that, I just think, honestly, I'm not trying to be funny. I just think it's poor parenting. I'm just giving you my opinion about it. I think that you should embrace it. If your child comes to you and they have, you know, this is how they're feeling as a parent, you should talk to your children. You should find out what's going on with your children. You should embrace that because you're going to love them because this is who they are. But to endorse them making a life-changing decision, what if he gets 18 and decides he wants to go to a prom? You've made this child so at such a young age become the poster child for transgenders at such a young age that this may cause some other psychological damage that he may feel like he can't turn around now because he has the weight of the world on his shoulders. I think this is very damaging to a child this young because a child this young shouldn't be making parental decisions. That's what parents are for. And I just think that for Gabriel to announce who he is, why, if that was the case, between Dwayne and his ex-wife, which is a parent, they're both active parents, that's something that they should have decided, and they should have, you know, decided how they was going to do that. It was not for her to do. I'm just being honest. Now, do I think some people are born gay or the wrong sex? I promise you, I do. I know God don't make mistakes, but I also know people are born that way. Sometimes people are placed in positions like that to do different things. And I do believe that some people are born that way. And I'm not saying that Dwayne and Savon's son is not that way. But what I am saying is at 12, to make a decision that he may can't go back from, I just think you should rethink that. As well as, you know, at 11 years old, him going to a gay parade, gay pride parade, where you have grown men, mostly pretty much grown people there. People just tend to dress with no clothes on. Let's just say that. Okay, clothes are sometimes very limited at the gay pride parade. I just didn't see that was a way for an 11-year-old to be at a gay pride parade. This is what I'm saying. This makes me think, and I'm just saying personally, you know, is it clout chasing? I mean, what is it? Because why does everybody in the world need to know that this is what your son is, especially at such a young age, where he can't take this back now? So when he gets 18, 19, 20, what if something changes? He can't take, this is always going to be, this is going to follow him for the rest of his life. So do you think it was really a good idea for a child that young, I mean, for you to put this out there like this? Why this wasn't something that you and Savon, your ex-wife, his mother, could have discussed, and you all could have decided what was the best way to handle this? this is what I'm saying. This is just how I feel about it. You're going to say Dwayne and Gabrielle are entitled to their opinions. Yes, they are. But what about Siobhan Wade Funches? Isn't she entitled to hers? And not on her opinion, but her feelings. I feel like this is a situation for Siobhan and Dwayne should have worked out. Gabrielle, I'm sorry you were about caviar. I'm just telling you the truth, how I feel, because what you would not want is for somebody to come out for your child and announce something about, has something to do with your child. You would think somebody did wrong, but you don't seem to think that's wrong. I think you owe his mother an apology. I really do. I think you owe Siobhan an apology. And I think, I pray that this young man remains strong, because let me tell you something. Kids have enough to deal with these days, and that's a difficult thing to deal with. It really is. But to put him in front of everybody, millions of households, to see where they're going to have opinions about it, how much do you really think children can withstand? He already has enough to deal with by feeling the way that he feels on the inside. So you're going to add this type of pressure to him, something that most adults can't even deal with, but you expect the child to be able to deal with this? I mean, psychologically, where are you putting this child? Seriously, like I just think it's wrong. And for Dwayne and Gabrielle to get upset with people because they have an opinion, well, y'all the one that put it out there. So you know people are going to have opinions. You shouldn't have put it out there if you didn't want nobody to say anything.
All right, so you guys just saw what Kiera had to say. So now what I find really interesting is that as of yesterday, if you guys don't know, I told you guys during the live stream that Siobhan Funches, she's like a reborn again Christian. She's a deacon. She runs her own podcast where she mainly talks about like Christianity and, you know, Christian topics and stuff like that. Now, after Kiera put out that post, Siobhan decided to do a podcast. And what was very interesting in that podcast is for some reason she decides to talk about pregnancy and birth. But while she's talking, she makes sure to mention her giving birth to a son. So almost low-key trying to plant seeds and let people know that she does not agree with what the Wades are doing. But because she can't come out and talk about it, I think this is her way of just planting seeds to let people know that, okay, I see you guys. I see my supporters. You know what I'm saying? This is my son. End of story. So y'all go ahead and listen to this small snippet of Siobhan speaking. And this was just from yesterday. Check this out. Baby,
let's go. Hey, Tea Sippers. To listen to the rest of this podcast, please go to Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Play, Stitcher, TunedIn, or AnchorFM.com, which is a free podcasting site. Thank you guys so much for the support, and stay tuned for the next video.